Good morning, students of class 4. Myself, your Mr. Sarkar, as your English teacher, will teach you today literature chapter 1, PP goes to the circus. Children, first of all, I will explain you the chapter and then I will give you some homework to do. So first, listen to the story carefully. PP was an extraordinarily strong, red-headed, 9-year-old girl whose father was a sea captain. She had grown up at sea and she didn't know much about life on land. Now let's read what happened when Pee-Pee's friend Tommy and Anika invited her to go with them to the circus. A circus had come to their little town and children were begging their parents for permission to go. Of course, Tommy and Anika were asked to go too. Their father gave them some money. Clutching the money tightly in their hands, they rushed over to Pee-Pee's house. Now Pee-Pee and Tommy was all out of breath because they had been running so fast. They wanted Pee-Pee to go along with them. Pee-Pee wanted to go with them too, but she didn't know much about land, so she misspelled the word circus as surcus. Tommy makes her understand by giving different examples about circus. As Anika says that it cost money, so she guessed that she can buy a circus. Now children, can she buy a circus? So Tommy makes her understand that it costs to go and look at. So she closes her eyes as it cost money to look. At last, they manage to explain to Pee-Pee what a circus really was. And they all went to see a circus. They came to sit on some beautiful red chairs right next to the ring. The place was marvelous for Pee-Pee and everything was new for her. So she looked around in astonishment. On a platform near the circus band suddenly began to play a thundering march. The curtain in front of the performer's entrance was drawn aside. A ringmaster in black frock coat came running into the ring, followed by a coal black horse. On its back stood a beautiful lady named Miss Carmencita. The horse trotted around in the sawdust and Miss Carmencita stood calmly on his back and smiled. Just as the horse passed Pee-Pee's seat, she stood on the horse's back and behind Miss Carmencita. Miss Carmencita was astonished that she nearly fell off the horse. But she began to push her hands behind her back to make Pee-Pee jump off. But Pee-Pee didn't listen to her and said that she can't alone have the fun because all other people have paid too. Then Miss Carmencita tried to jump off herself, but that too didn't work either because Pee-Pee was holding her tightly around the waist. The audience started laughing. They thought it was a funny act to see them. But the ringmaster didn't laugh. He turned towards an attendant and made a sign to go and stop the horse. The ringmaster asked her to get off the horse. So Pee-Pee was disappointed to do so, as she thought that the funny act was already over. Pee-Pee looked very sad. And she thought that the ringmaster was annoyed with her, but she didn't know the reason behind. She skipped off the horse and went back to her seat. But then two huge guards came to remove her from the circus. They took hold of her and tried to lift her up. They couldn't do it. Pee-Pee sat absolutely still and it was impossible to budge her although they tried as hard as they could. At last, they shrugged their shoulders and went off. Pee-pee smiled and sat and watched the rest of the show. Now, children, read the chapter thoroughly. Learn the spellings from the chapter. Learn the word meanings given in the book and write the word meanings given below. Make sentences with the words given below. Write the reference to the context that is given in your textbook. Word meanings you copy in your notebook. Extraordinary means very unusual. Feast means a hand with the fingers close together tightly. Goggled means look with wide open eyes. Astonishment, very great surprise. To spilled, to accidentally come out of a container. Attendant, a person whose job is to serve or help people in a public place. Annoyed, feeling angry. But to move or make something move a little. Shrugged, to lift your shoulders as a way of showing that you do not know something. Now you have to make sentences with these following words. Tightly. Now, second, marvelous. Circus. Audience. Annoyed. Shiny. Funny. Careless. Thundering. Spilled. Okay. Now, here I conclude saying that stay at home, do your studies, and I will come back soon. Till then, goodbye.